Shaking from fear, trembling with anger, or paralyzing anxiety. I think we all agree that extreme emotions can have a remarkable effect on our bodies. But what if I tell you that stressors can have a lasting effect on the body, like people not being able to walk, talk, or see anymore, sometimes even years after they experience something extremely stressful? Crazy, right? We call this conversion disorder, and I'll tell you all about it in this video. Please don't forget to like and subscribe. When you experience conversion disorder, something is going wrong with the signals from the brain to the parts of the body. Stress, for example, caused by a traumatic event, is subconsciously converted into physical problems on a motor and sensory level. These problems can differ from issues with swallowing to abnormal movements of certain body parts. Freud argued that people with conversion disorder repress the memories of this stressful event, yet at the same time convert the emotional pain into physical symptoms. You might be thinking, this is bullshit. Think again. Brain imaging results appear to support the existence of conversion disorders. Some research even shows the link between suppressing trauma and brain parts responsible for motor functions. However, the studies have all been too small to be confident of the generalizability of their findings. So more research is necessary. Meta-analyses, however, show that stressful life events are substantially more common in people with functional neurological disorders than in healthy controls and patient controls. Let me give you a concrete example. This is Lucy. She lived in a foster family from the age of 12 to 20 and was sexually abused every week by her foster dad. She has a lot of difficulties walking and standing due to cramps in her legs and arms. Therefore, she needs a wheelchair to move around. After seeing lots of doctors, she is eventually diagnosed with conversion disorder. During the treatment, Lucy says she can't stand being confronted with her past. The words Lucy uses might be important. Why? Well, research shows the impact of language on our mental state and behavior. In an experiment, a group of students was given the exercise of making sentences with words. Half of them got words related to being old, like bald and gray. The other half got neutral words. After the exercise, the first group walked noticeably slower than the first group. Astonishing, right? Back to Lucy. During the trauma treatment, her therapist asks her to stand up. She tells Lucy she can withstand the horrible feelings she experiences. Note the importance of language. After lots of therapeutic sessions, Lucy eventually experiences fewer cramps and can walk better. Lucy received EMDR treatment, but also other forms of therapy, like hypnosis, can be beneficial. Okay, this is a very extreme case. However, it shows the huge impact our environment can have on our mental and physical state, often without us being aware of this. In our society, we constantly feel the pressure of having a perfect life and body. The impact on our unconscious and by consequence conscious thinking, behavior and physical body is self-evident. So, couldn't this mean we create our own mental and psychological illnesses like depression or anorexia? Something to think about.